Mark,
Luke,
except Matthew.
Okay.
One person wrote it.
Okay.
And he never said that there were people who saw it.
Okay.
And the graves was open.
Yep.
And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall wake some everlasting.
Yep.
So now you still believe it, correct?
I believe what is there.
That's what I'm, so you have no problem.
I don't
someone, know. No, let me. You have no problem for someone to narrate something to you, even though they
because
were...
Because his sources were many.
Let me finish my point. Even though...
His sources were many.
I'm just speaking.
Mohammed had only one source.
Even though there were no eyewitnesses.
So
alhamdulillah, we had that review.
His sources were many.
I just made you call Paul a liar. Therefore, listen, Paul should be taken...
Wait. The fact that I didn't believe Paul...
Fami.
Doesn't mean that he's a liar.
Let me speak. Fami, instead of coming to speak his corner, talking about our religion, you accept that in your book, there are You just accepted that there is in your gospel someone who is a liar. So you should busy yourself to take.
I never said
gospel.
So. You are a liar.
You said she's a liar.
I said I did not believe.
He says a liar.
If I did not believe you, does that mean you are a liar?
Yeah.
Go back to school and learn. If you follow Mohammed, you suffer mental deficiency.
Anyway,
that is why you need to come to Jesus.
And the Christians out there, this Christian here, he's helping me.
Sorry. That's why you need to come to Jesus. If you don't come to Jesus,
when I ask him,
you go to
God became a man. Did he change? We know that technically.
He doesn't change.
We know that
Jesus was a Muslim.
God was a baby.
Pardon?
As a baby.
Yeah, better than Mohammed the liar. Mohammed the liar and the murderer. Oh, he's a liar. Just sorry.
See,
you slave.
Jesus and his father, when he says I am the father of one, is that oneness, oneness of divinity or oneness of purpose?
Oneness in spirit.
No, my
oneness
question
of purpose.
Is oneness either of divinity or of purpose. Which one? Because the same oneness he applied there. He says just as I was and I and you are one, you the disciples are also one with us. So the oneness that God and Jesus has with the disciples is of divinity or of purpose?
Let's go through a list of things what God is.
Sorry.
He's the King
before
of peace.
Before you move on from this verse, because I know Christians don't like this verse. They want to take it away. They want to remove it from the Bible. Right? But you can't. No matter what you try, you can't remove this verse. Because now we're in a digital world. Right? You can't just make your own Bible anymore. It's just there. So, when Jesus says, me, the Father, and the disciples are all one, is this oneness of divinity or a purpose?
Purpose in what they're going to do.
Purpose. So when he says, just I and the Father are one, you also will be like one with us. So there is no difference between this oneness. That means if you say, the Father and Jesus is one, and the Father, Jesus, and the disciples are one, and that later oneness of the disciples is the purpose, then his oneness with the Father is also with the purpose. So nothing to do with divinity. So you have nothing to share again from Christ about who's the one true God. He clearly said the Father is the only one true God.
See, the Father is the King of Peace. Jesus is known as the Prince of Peace in the Bible, which is basically
the King of Peace.
Yeah, but it's
where does it say King?
It doesn't say King of Peace. It says Prince of Peace.
If the God, the Father, is King of Peace, and we have another King of Peace, then you can.
So the true peace comes from him.
No. You can't let you have that. King of Peace and King of Peace. That's what you can compare it to.
That makes you one in purpose already.
Sorry.
Because you both
do
have
you
peace.
Have that title? The same title?
To me?
No. The Father and the Son.
Yeah.
Is Jesus the King of Peace?
He's known as the Prince of Peace.
So he's not the King of Peace. Right. Try again. Another one.
If you're
is there anything in the Bible that you've learned from your studying or from your priest where Jesus is also part of this one true God?
If you go to Isaiah, you've got plenty of scriptures in Isaiah.
I don't want to talk about Jesus or what.
heard of Isaiah talk about Jesus Christ and says he's part of one God?
He talks about Son of Mary, Son of the woman.
Isaiah talk about Jesus Mary. The name Mary is not even present in Isaiah.
So not what? The actual name.
So don't say it's the son of Mary.
He's the son of a woman. Sorry.
Are you a son of a woman?
I am.
Good. Okay, let's see what he applies to you. What else? Does he say in Isaiah that he is part of the one true God?
He doesn't say it like that.
Right, so we're not interested in Isaiah. Is there anything in the entire Bible where, apart from the Father, someone else is one true God?
In Revelation.
Okay, where does Revelation say someone else is one true God?
Someone else.
Along with the Father. Because the Father, in the Judeo-Christian belief system, is God, the source of everything. Right? God in all.
If you read,
you call him the Father, but actually that is the God Almighty. So where do you find in the entirety of the Bible someone else other than the Father is also one true God?
In the Epistle of John, in one of those books, it says that the Holy Spirit is God.
And you ask him about me, Satan is the God of this world too. Yeah, is he one
angel.
True God?
He's an angel, but he's not actually a God.
Sorry, it does say in black and white, he's the God of this world. Right. So where does it say Satan is the only true God?
It doesn't say.
It doesn't. So in the verses that you quoted, does it say Holy Spirit is the only true God?
No, it doesn't say.
Right. So don't bring those verses in. Try again. Is there anything in the entirety of the New Testament and the Old Testament where other than the Father, there's someone who is the only true God? Apart from the Father.
Doesn't say it like that, no.
So it doesn't exist. So you should go with what your scripture says if you're really a scripture believing Christian.
Right.
Right. So if you believe in your book, believe in your book. Your book says the only true God is the Father. So don't go against your book.
No, but if you don't believe that Jesus was here before Abraham.
That has nothing to do with one true God.
If he was here before Abraham, he can't be a normal human being, can he? Because how can he be here before Abraham?
Melchizedek. Was he before Abraham?
Yes, he was.
Is he God?
But he was God before Abraham.
Is he God?
No.
Right, so it doesn't matter. You can be someone before Abraham or before Noah, it doesn't make you God. So try again. Is there anything in the entire New Testament where someone else, other than the Father, is the only true God?
No, it isn't written like that.
Then why do you invent something when your scripture doesn't teach you that? At least say, I believe in my scripture.
I believe in the scripture, yes.
And the scripture says the only true God is who?
Father and the Son.
No.
Okay, nice talking to you.
Michael.
Pressure.
You know, it's a good conversation, but it still is
wrong. Michael, you have to be honest. You have to be honest. Scripture does not say the Father and Son that the God. It's clear that the God. The
See,
Father.
Jesus said, me and my Father, we are one. Because we are one in spirit, we are one in purpose.
Can you continue? What the next verse says? As you and me are one, the disciples are one in ourselves. One. So the disciples of God as well?
No, they're not.
So why the same verse? Why do you stop that line with the Father and Son? Why don't you include the Jesus instead of disciples?
The disciples are human beings. They're not.
What
they're
Jesus,
not one with the Father.
Jesus was a man as well.
No. Jesus.
He said Jesus 100% God, 100% man.
Yes, he became a man.
So why are you saying no?
No, he became a man.
Sorry, you are just interfering without my permission.
We do that all the time.
No, no, listen, what I'm trying to say, I accept what you're saying. But Michael,
I want to ask you a question. Do you believe Jesus existed before the creation? Before everything was created, Jesus existed.
Even I was existed before creation.
No, you were
Maru was not with the God.
No, you never existed.
It was there. No, was
we never existed. No one ever existed.
We were in God's body.
I'm asking you a question.
I'll give you that proof from your own Bible.
Yeah, go, you can show me.
It shows, it tells the God, we are in God's mind.
So that you don't exist
we were in
because
mind.
What I'm saying,
hear me
the question
out.
I'm
hear
asking
out.
You
not physically, but our root.
No,
so the root was there.
You never existed.
Brother,
never
existed. Listen to me. You are referring to John 1:1. Am I right?
I can go in the Old Testament.
Tell me.
I will show you the existence of Christ from the Old Testament. No, not from the
Old Testament. Is it Christ you're going to show me?
Huh?
You're going to show me Christ?
Yes, the Son of
God. Is it prophecy or name Jesus?
The name was never revealed.
So how do you?
Until he
came. So how do you? Same criteria. Same criteria apply to me.
No.
Same criteria apply to me. Because I'm not Jesus.
It's going
to
make sense.
It's
going to make sense.
Hear me out.
It's going to make sense.
Hear me out. Michael.
I'm going to show you.
Same criteria you're applying to Jesus, apply to me.
No, it doesn't.
Sir, apply to me.
It doesn't.
Apply to me and I will prove that I was there.
No, it doesn't.
Because
why?
There.
Why?
Tell me.
Why? Over all the prophets ever existed, only Jesus who came and claimed to say, God, no one ever seen his form, no one ever gone to heaven, but only him who came down, and who knows him, who knows his form, and who was with him from the beginning.
Okay.
And he said, he's my father. And he said, everything that belongs, I'm finishing, everything that belongs, that God has created, everything of God belong to him.
Okay.
Because he is the what do you call it, the hands,
once,
the ear.
Once you finish,
so
you
let
know.
Me read.
No.
Let's
Michael,
me read.
No, you have to give me time.
Yeah.
Now, we're going back to what he was saying, that guy. He was saying, basically, he was getting to the point where, you know, God, Jesus says, there was only one true God, my Father who is in heaven. Now, the question really is, where does it say that Jesus is God? That's basically what we're trying to do.
Jesus is saying, from that verse, I'm not God.
Talk about one son.
Michael,
and
you're an English-speaking man.
Talk about one
English
son
is not my first language.
I can read you
English is your first
Old
language.
Testament, not New Testament.
Only
huh?
Exclude every
not,
other
what
people,
is divine,
every other element. If I drink, I can only drink
divine.
Water.
God did not sleep.
I cannot drink Coca-Cola,
Seven
or Pepsi. Only exclude everything.
Yeah, no
if Jesus own mouth, and I just read the Greek.
But that's what I'm saying. Jesus meaning
as well.
Was incarnation.
What it says?
It was
mono,
here. Begin from
mono means I speak Greek.
It was
you cannot include anything in that. Be honest.
Monotheist.
Jesus is saying God is the mono. Theo.
Yeah, the Holy One of
God. God, the
even
Father, the
demon,
is the only God.
The demon testified, you the
he
Holy
the
One of
only,
God.
Not false.
Time
only
has not come.
True God.
Are you come to judge us? Sorry.
Michael.